Basil Chapman, first off, we want to thank you from TFNN, all the producers, all the folks here. Folks, Basil sends us these nuts every year, and they're phenomenal, and everyone goes crazy. And we want to thank you, man, because it's always a pleasure. People go wild. Great way to kick off the 2022, man. Thank you.
Well, it's my pleasure. You guys do a fantastic job. You make it really easy for us hosts. All we have to do is show up, do our homework, and present our show, and we love that.
Pretty cool. Great. Yum, yum. Ooh.
I know.
Okay, what are we looking at?
I'm going to give Pistachio here in Watertown a plug because...
You know, Basil, I use it now to give it to people. It's phenomenal, man. I mean, it's
fresh
and
terrific, yeah.
Because they make them right there. I see the machines, the whole bit, right? Yeah, right. Pretty cool, man.
So anyway, so market-wise, we're talking about monster moves intraday for the last couple of days. What's really important about this is there's a pattern that I talk about a lot, and that's just I like to look at the market as basically three patterns, straight up, straight down, that's one, cup formation, that's two, and the arch formation, that's three. And then you can get a combination of one and three or one and two. I'll keep this up here to show you. You see this H pattern here? The reason why it's red is if you take out this left side low, you can go quite a lot lower. And on the right is the inverse Y green, because if you take out the left side high, you can go quite a bit higher. And you can see, in fact, right here on the chart, this is the daily chart of the Dow, right at that peak D, you saw there was like an inverse Y, and look how high you went to that doji candle at the top, 36,565, 8th of November. That's actually the day that we shorted. We didn't keep that short long enough, but it was a nice timing tool that we used for the Chapman Wave methodology. And we went right to the 200 period exponential moving average. And we've been trying to trade from that on the upside. So what we did today, after those three very sharp pullbacks, we went long the diamonds as a trade, because the pattern, you can see this pattern. I'm going to keep this right here for the moment. This H pattern, you can see we've got to look at that long leg down, and now we've started the arch formation. And there are two patterns actually that I talk about. The other one is this, where prices go up and then it makes lower highs and much lower lows. And then it suddenly forms a base of support and it reverses and it takes out that resistance line. So I call that I like to nickname my chart pattern. This is called the falling axe formation. It can also be inverted, but right now it's a falling axe with a lower, it looks like an axe with a handle on a slope. And what we've got here is exactly that in this Chapman Wave inside track repellent zone at the top part of the trend line. That's this trend line here. There it is. That's where we arched over and came back. So I said to subscribers this morning, we're going long before the open. This is a trade. We are still long from, we're still holding our core position from last year, March the 23rd, the day of the low. That's where we started with options. And then a week later, we got the diamond call, the diamonds themselves. And what we've done now is we've just added a trading position. And I said, watch out for the 9 and 14 period moving averages. Just move this away for now. The 9 and 14 period moving averages, because that's where you'd expect this to stall. That was fantastic support on the way up. Every time it pulled back, that's where it bounced. When it's shot through, I think it was 2 days, 3 days ago, it went right through, and now you've come back again. So the next level of resistance will be this inside track repellent zone. If for whatever reason, I don't care what the reason is, if the Dow continues to rally and it takes out 36,189, that's the high that was made last week, that's going to be very important, because then maybe we have a chance to get to the all-time high of 36,565. I'm expecting that this is going to be a strong resistance area, although we are looking at a number of stocks that have just been hammered. You know, people talk about this as, oh, it's not too bad, but there are individual stocks that were leading the market up that have taken 20, 30, 40, and even 50% hits. So individually, that's something to be taking note of. Now, what's really important about this is that within the weekly chart, you can see we're just in basically an up channel, and the monthly chart, we're still near the highs. So this is something that I'm going to monitor very closely for subscribers. We've kept some of our core positions. We've taken profits there, but we've also kept core for some of the stocks that we've had for quite some time. And they're doing very well. I didn't want to overdo anything today. I thought if there was a big rally today, these are the stocks that should participate, and they are. But at the same time, I'm trying to find low price. I'm talking about single-digit stocks that I've been monitoring for some time that are doing very well and that are holding well. So for subscribers, I'm trying to see that we've raised cash. I want to put cash to work now on the long side on very low-priced stocks that have the potential to avoid any big downturn because they're in areas that are kind of away from the marketplace itself. So it's being very selective. And that's kind of the posture that we're in. We've raised cash. We've got very select positions on the upside. We have no, and right at this moment, we have no shorts. I expect that in another few days or maybe early next week, we will start putting shorts back on again. So it's a fascinating market, somewhat overbought. It needs a bit of a rest. I'm still saying it's more a rest. Unless the Dow at some point in January takes out 33,500, that'll be serious. But in the meantime, I think it's a very well-organized rotational correction that we're looking at, and that's kind of how I want to treat it. I don't want to get too carried away either way.
Yeah, you know, it's intriguing. I mean, Tommy on his show this morning, you know, had the chart up from basically 1997. And I have that up now, folks, okay? But, you know, you can see the type of consolidation, you know, from 2000, you know, the market goes sideways for 13 years and then just never looks back, man. I mean, this doesn't happen, folks, just so you understand something.
What you're talking about, Tom, I've got from 2003. I can go back further, but it's from the low of October 2003 at 768.
Yeah.
In the S&P, look at these beautiful channels, a beautiful channel that went all the way to 2008. Then, of course, we got that huge 2007-2008, big pullback. We were actually lucky. We bought the very low on the diamonds the day of the low of March the 6th of 2009. And look, another beautiful channel. And now is the first time that we've gone very vertically up. But even this is in an up channel. And the S&P is still in leg B, although the futures made an extension, but the actual cash is in leg B. We'll see if it makes a peak B.
And folks, it's very easy to get Basil's newsletter. Come over to our website at TFNN. You hit newsletters, the opening call right on the left-hand side. Basil, have a great one, safe one. We look forward to the show tomorrow.